Hey guys, I'm back again. So I just wanted to post up a quick review of the Tesco Connect 7, which is a very budget Windows 8.1 tablet from Tesco. Very similar to the Lenovo Lynx 7 tablet in that it runs full Windows 8.1, which is very nice. And Tesco has an offer on at the moment that you can get it for very cheap in combination with club card points as well. So I was quite interested to see how the performance would be on such a cheap device. And I've done some testing with it now, so I've got to grips with the strong points of it as well as some shortcomings. But first things first, I have to say I'm still very impressed with the build quality of the device. It feels very solid for saying it's so cheap. It is a bit of a fingerprint magnet on the back, and is a little bit slippery when you're holding it. Could have been a bit more grippy, but for the price, as I said, you really can't complain. There's no build quality issues with the device that I've noticed. Everything seems to be very sturdy. I do like the way that they've maximised the screen compared to some other 7-inch tablets as well, with quite small bezels. It would have been nice if they'd used an oleophobic kind of coating on the front of the display. As you can see, it does pick up quite a lot of fingerprints, and it would have been nice if they'd have built in some sort of double tap or like gesture where you can wake the screen. But these are just minor niggles. Obviously you do get your connectivity at the top, which is quite nice, and the ability to expand to a micro SD card as well. And you get these kind of plasticky buttons, which feel solid but not particularly premium. The actual display is 216 ppi, and I found it to be a very pleasant display for the price anyway, and it gives you very decent colour reproduction and viewing angles. As you can see, it's quite sunny where I am at the moment, but you can clearly see the screen. One thing which is a bit annoying is that there's no auto brightness, so you do have to keep going into the settings and changing it, but as you can see, it does go very bright, so you shouldn't have any issues viewing the screen. It would have been nice if they'd have built in some sort of brightness toggle though, in a more accessible place. But overall, I'm quite happy with the display. Even your web pages, very viewable. Go to The Verge. So you can see, if I click on a news story, can see that the text is very clear and not too distorted or pixelated, which is cool. It is a TFT type display, which I don't think means it's got the IPS kind of technology, but to me it seems like it is an IPS display because it's got very nice viewing angles. So the display is very decent for this device and very expansive as well for saying it's 7 inches. But other than that, you're getting a quad core processor, which is a Bay Trail processor from Intel. And it's a Z3735G, and it's backed up with 1 gig of RAM. And I was a bit hesitant in regards to what the performance would be like when you're doing your multitasking, etc. But but I'm happy to say that it handles pretty much everything that I've thrown at it without any significant lags or like problems. I'm thinking that the reason is probably because it's using an SSD as well for the main like hard drive kind of storage, which means that you can probably use memory from that very quickly, not as quickly as a RAM, but obviously better than using like a traditional hard disk for its paging resources, which is getting quite technical there. But basically, it's where the computer uses like memory from the hard disk as opposed to the RAM to do stuff. So I think that it benefits from the SSD, should I say, in there, and makes the 1 gig RAM not too much of an issue. As you can see, going in and out of stuff is very nice and smooth. Maps seems to be even smoother than Google Maps on my own laptop, which is quite strange. As you can see, the gaming performance on the device is very acceptable. Not the smoothest of performance, but I was pleasantly surprised at how the Intel processor managed it. Everything looks very colourful and frame rate is decent. One thing which is a bit annoying about the tablet is the position of the speaker. So it's positioned there so that when you're playing games, you'll cover it up most likely, which is quite annoying. So you have to kind of move your hand like that. But thankfully, a lot of games support reorientation of the screen, so you can flip it upside down and then it should get rid of that problem. But you know, I'm generally quite impressed with the gaming performance of the device. I mean, for £50 you can't really complain. I'm not sure what the exact graphics processor is in this device, but if it's by Intel, it maybe is an integrated solution similar to your Intel graphics HD. I think really the camera and the sound output are the two main areas which let the device down. If I could quickly show you the camera, you can see it's quite a basic interface. You don't get much to actually customize. You can go into the settings and change the aspect ratio from 16:9 to 4:3, as well as get like a reduction on the flicker for when you're filming. But in general, you need literally the best of light to get anything which is usable. I've taken a few decent pictures with it, which are more than usable, I guess. Serviceable, I could say. But nothing to replace your phone. But the video is about the same as well. So very basic stuff, but I'm sure if you gave it to a kid, then you know they'd be happy with it. And the sound output as well, I can quickly show you that. So it's very low kind of thing, and you may struggle to hear it if you've got your TV on or something. So I do advise using like a Bluetooth speaker or headphones with this device. You know, you can expand the inbuilt memory, which is 32 gigs SSD. You can expand it using a micro SD, which is very nice, as well as connect to a TV through a HDMI port. So there are little things there which do help the experience. Also, there is a Windows button up here, which can quickly get you back to what you were doing. So if you do get lost, as you could see there, I was probably getting a bit lost, you can quickly press that button. But in regards to the actual Windows 8.1 on the tablet, I still think that it's got some way to go, really, compared to your Android operating system. It's getting there. It's very better than it was before. And as you've seen from me opening up different stuff, everything opens up very nicely and slick. But I think the main issue that I find with it is sometimes I just really like to have a home button here, or a persistent kind of tray here where I could click that and then go back into what I was doing before. I keep finding myself like clicking down here expecting it to for me to go back, but then I remember you have to do it either this way, which takes you back to your previous activity, or you can basically swipe to the left here and then click on start there, or you can press a button up here. Another thing which is a bit annoying is the fact that when you go to type in something in the URL, it doesn't automatically come up with the keyboard. I have to actually manually tell it to come up. I've had a look for a setting to change this, but I can't seem to find one at the moment. But if you can't change that, it is a bit annoying, if we to be honest. In terms of the battery life, I found it to be about the same as Nexus 7 2013, so I don't think you're going to have any issues with battery life on this device. It's very serviceable, but not quite as good as your Lenovo Yoga tablets. I think the thing that I really do like about this device is the fact that it's running the Windows 8.1 full edition, so you can do real kind of multitasking on it. You do get some multitasking on Android tablets, but for this, like, you can go into this, go back out of it, then do something else completely different, like you would on a desktop. So it feels like a desktop experience, but using a tablet. So I do like the multitasking kind of possibilities that are available on this device, which you don't get with some Android operating systems, particularly the stock ones. You do get them on your TouchWiz devices, but still it feels a bit unnatural compared to Windows. So very good for your multitasking on this device. And I think that about covers it. So you know, this is quite a steal, really, for the price it is now. I think normally they're about 70-80 quid, but you can get one now for about 50 quid from Tesco. and it does everything that you'd need it to do, really, for a small tablet, just to consume media, browse the internet, reply to your emails and things like that. So I definitely recommend it and give it a thumbs up. And yeah, you know, I hope you found the review interesting, and I will see you again shortly. Cheers.